Hello everyone, so this is the fourth part of your semiconductor device in which we are going to study our logic gates. Very simple, what most of you know what it is. Okay, so just I am revising you, like analog signal. In analog signal, what is happening? If there is some voltage V0 and then V1, then your net will be V0 plus V1. That means 1 plus 1 will become 2. Are you getting my point? This is for analog signal. Analog signal, that means continuous signal. But in your digital signal, we are having only two inputs, 0 and 1. Only 0 and 1. So if you are adding 0 plus 1, it will 1. When you are adding 1 plus 1, then also it is 1. This is the difference here. Okay, here you will get only in terms of 0 and 1. Nothing more than that. Only 0 and 1. So we have to play with this 0 and 1. This is our input. So for this input, we have to make a gates for our desired output. So we are using a gates, logic gates, in which you have to remember this symbol, formula and gate. So main is OR and AND. In OR, what we are doing? We are adding A plus B. In AND, what we are doing? We are multiplying A into B. Symbol is like this. Okay, I am telling you like here. See, like this. This is for OR. This is for OR. Here input is X and Y and let the result is Z. So OR means X plus Y. OR means X plus Y. Then what will happen if your X and Y and Z making a truth table? Okay. If your X is 0, Y is 0, then 0 plus 0 is 0. If X is 0, Y is 1, then 0 plus 1 is 1. If your X is 1, Y is 0, then 1 plus 0 is 1. And if it is 1 and 1, then 1 plus 1 is also 1. Are you getting my point? So this one will be your truth table for OR. OR means addition, A plus B. Addition. OR means addition. Symbol is this. Simple, nothing more than this. No, you don't have to remember anything more than this. Symbol, what is the formula and what is the truth table. Similarly, if I will talk about C, here you can see AND. AND means A into B and symbol is like this. Symbol is like this. This means if this is X, this is Y, then this is Z. Then the Z is equal to X into Y. This symbol means Z is equal to X into Y. Now, what will be the truth table? See, here only I am rubbing this. Okay. Z is equal to X into Y. So, 0 into 0 is 0. 1 into 0 into 1 is 0. 0 into 1 is 0. 1 into 1 is 1. Okay. So, here you are getting 1 only when your both the input is 1. Are you getting my point? So this is your truth table for your AND. Very simple. For OR, what is it you are doing? A plus B. If any one of the is 1, then you will get the answer 1. That means if any one of is on, then you will get the answer on. Circuit 0 and 1. That means on circuit or off circuit. Only 0 and 1. We are only playing with 0 and 1. So what is the OR gate? OR gate in which you are doing A plus B. That means if any one of the input is 1, then you will get the answer 1. And if both are 0, then only you will get the answer 0. And in multiplication, what you are doing? If any one of the input is 0, then you will get the output 0. If both are 1 or all are 1, then only you will get the output 1. Is it simple? Clear? OR, AND, AND. OR, AND, AND. Okay. Now all. See. What is NOT? NOT means A bar. NOT means A bar. If your input is 1, see if your input is 1, A, then A bar. A bar means 0. And if your input is 0, then A bar is 1. Just opposite, if it is 1, it will become 0. If it is 0, it will become 1. NOT means NOT gate. Very simple. Symbol is, you can see here, see. Symbol, you can, sorry, here, you can see the symbol. Simple. NOT. Dot. This is a symbol. So if this is 1, then this one will become 0. And if this is 0, then it will become 1. Very simple, nothing to tell here. OR gate, AND gate, NOR gate, NOT gate. Now NOR, see, AND we have written in front of OR. So just opposite of OR, whatever you are getting the result of OR, just opposite it. If it is 1, then 0, if it is 0, then 1. So it is denoted by this same symbol with a dot. This same symbol with a dot, with a circle, a small circle, like this. This means NOR, opposite of OR. So in OR, what you are getting? C. If I will make a truth table, A, B and C. If this is A, this is B and this is C. If 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. If it is 0, 0, what you will get in OR? In OR, what you will get, if it is 0, 0, then 0, 1, 1, 1. If any one of the input is 1, then you will get the answer 1 in OR. So, your NOR will be opposite of it. NOR will be opposite of it. If it is 0, then 1. If it is 1, then 0. If it is 1, then 0. If it is 1, then 0. Opposite of OR. NOR is opposite of OR. Are you getting my point? Very simple. Similarly, NAND. NAND is opposite of AND. That means A into B bar. A into B bar. Simple denoted by like this. Is it clear to everyone? Is it clear? Very simple. Gates. If you remember all this symbol, what is means? Now, XOR and XNOR. Very less used. Mostly used is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This 5 are used. Mostly these 5 are used. These 2 are very rarely used. But okay, you must know. What is XOR? A into B bar plus B into A bar. Okay? And what is XNOR? A into B plus A bar into B bar. Let me drop all these things. What is XOR? XOR means A into B bar. That means A into B opposite plus B into A opposite. Are you getting my point? Bar. Okay, XOR. And what is XNOR? AB, okay, plus AB plus AB bar. AB plus AB bar. A bar into B bar. So let's make a truth table for this. We are going to make a truth table for this. Let's take this. Copy. Any new page? Let me add a page. Okay. See, let's make a truth table for these two. XOR and XNOR. How to make a truth table? How to make a truth table? For XOR, we are making first for XOR. Let me rub it. This you can make. Second one you can make. I am making for XOR. So for XOR, A, B, A bar, B bar, A into B bar, B into A bar, and then final answer. Okay, here is your A, here is your B, here is your A bar, here is your B bar, and here you will get A, B bar, and here B, A bar, and then final answer, A, B bar, plus B, A bar. Okay, so what is the possibility? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. This much only? Okay, now just tell me, if your A is 0, then A bar will be 1. A bar will be 1. Opposite of this, complete. See, opposite of this will be your A bar. So what it will come, just tell me fast, 1, 1, 0, 0. Is it clear? Very easy. Is it clear? Now what is B bar? B bar is opposite of B. Opposite of B. So what it will come? It will come 1, 0, 1, 0. 0 will become 1 and 1 will become 0. Simple. Now what you have to do, A into B bar, A into B bar. That means what you have to do, this A into B bar. We have to multiply these two. We have to multiply this two. So in multiplication, what we have said, if any one of the input is 0, then you will get the 0. So here also you will get 0. Here also you will get 0. Here you will get 1. See, both is 1. Both is 1. So here you will get 1. And here also 0. So 0, 0, 1, 0. What will get? 0, 0, 1, 0. Now here what you have to do, multiply B into A bar. That means B into A bar. We have to multiply these two. These two we have to multiply. So 0 into 1. See. Okay, where it has gone? Just wait a minute. Okay, so see what we have to do, B into A bar. That means we have to multiply this and this. So 0 into 1 is 0. 1 into 1 is 1. 0 into 0 is 0. 1 into 0 is 0. Are you getting my point? Now what we have to do? What we have to do is add this and this. That means we have to add these two things. Okay. So 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. So this is your output for your XOR. That means in XOR, what is the symbol? This is the symbol. This is the symbol for XOR. Are you getting my point? So in XOR, if this is your X, this is Y, then this one will be your Z. This result will be your Z. That means if it is 0 and 0, input is your 0 and 0, you will get 0. If your answer is 0 and 1, you will get 1. If your answer is 1 and 0, you will get 1. And if your input is 1 and 1, then you will get answer 0. Are you getting my point? Very simple. How to make this truth table? It is clear. You have to do is only remember this formula and symbol. Nothing more than that. Gate, formula and symbol. Gate, formula and symbol. Simple mathematics. It is nothing but only a mathematics. A plus and in multiplication, what it will come. In addition, 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. And 1 plus 1 is 1. Simple mathematics. Are you getting my point? And in multiplication, 0 into 0 is 0. 0 into 1 is 1. 1 into 0 is 0. 1 into 1 is 1. Is that clear? If A is equal to 1, then A bar is going to be equal to 0. And if A is 0, then A bar is going to be equal to 1. This much you have to remember. Nothing more than that. Complete gate is over. And now I will give you the last year problems also of gate, and you will be able to solve. Okay, just remember, NOR and NAND is known as universal gate because you can make any gate by using this gate. NOR and NAND. Just remember, NOR and NAND is known as universal gate. Why? Because by using these gates, you can make any gate. You can make any gate. Is that clear? Okay, just. So we have completed all of these things. Now we will do last year JEE mains problem. What we will do? Last year JEE mains problem. Okay. So now we will see last year JEE mains problem. Some of that we have already seen. Okay. Like this one I have already given. Which one is forest biased? Very, 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 very easy question. Okay. After that, this is the question from logic gate. A, B, C, D are inputs. See, A, B, C, D are inputs. Your A, B, C, D is input to a gate and X is the output. X is your output. Then as per the following time graph, the gate is which of the gate graph it is given for A, B, C, D, and X. So you have to tell whether it is a which gate, OR gate or NAND gate or AND gate or NOT gate. So if you see in your result, this one is 0 and other all is 1. 1 is 0. And other all is 1. So it is more probable that it is OR, not NOR. From NOT and OR, it is OR. Sorry, in AND and OR. AND and all OR. What is happening in AND? What I told you, if anyone is 0, then result will be 0. Are you remembering what I told you? If any of the input is 0, then your output will be 0. And in OR, what I said, if any of the input is 1, then your output is 1. So we are getting more output. We are getting more output. See, from here only it is clear. From here, first part, here to here, see, this and this inverse, first part, A is also 0, B is also 0, C is also 0, D is also 0. All are 0. That's why your X is 0. And in other all, if you see, 1, any 1 is positive, always. Sum is positive. Here this is positive, this is positive. Here this is positive, here this is positive, here this is positive. Now here this is positive. Here this is positive, here this is positive. Everywhere one of the input among A, B, C, D is positive. That means 1 is 1. That's why we are getting always 1. So it is very simple. Here from here only it is looking that it is OR gate. It is OR gate. Are you getting my point? If maximum is 0 and when maximum is 0 and very minimum is 1, then what we will think in the terms that it must be AND. Okay, if you will not see both, then you will move to something other. Are you getting my point? So here it is clear, all is 1. When any one of the input A, B, C, D is 1, then your output is 1. When your all A, B, C, D, all 4 are 0, then only your output is 0. Are you getting my point? Is this clear to everyone? To everyone, is this clear? So two questions we have seen. This third question also I already told you before while we are doing the questions, while we are looking into the theories. Now this question, this type of question, 5 questions we have done. So please attempt it. Pause the screen and attempt. The reading of the ammeter, you have to find the reading of this ammeter. For a silicon diode, it is given it is silicon diode in the given circuit is. Very simple, it is given that it is silicon diode. See, it is given. And I told you to remember some formulas. Just attempt this. Pause the screen for 1 minute and attempt. Pause the screen for 1 minute and attempt. Okay, let's see. So what it is given that, let me come. Now what it is given that your input total voltage that you have supplied is 3 volt. Okay, now here is your silicon diode, and what I told you, for silicon your knee voltage is 0.7 volt. I already told you. So out of 3 volt, 0.7 volt is across silicon diode, then how much it will left? 3 minus 0.7, which is 2.3. So total potential difference across your resistance is 2.3 volt. And what is the resistance? Resistance is given 200 ohm. What is the resistance given? Resistance is given 200 ohm. So what will be the current? I. V is equal to IR, Ohm's law. So I is equal to V by R. What is V? 2.3. By what is R? 200. So what you can say that? It is 23 by 2 into 10 raised to power minus 3 ampere. So it will come approximately 11.5. Approximately or what? Accurate, 11.5 milliampere. What you can write? 11.5 milliampere. Very easy question. I told you this type of questions. 5 questions I have given you in the example. Ab kya bachche ki jaan loge? Chalo. Next question for you is on the screen. Truth table. Truth table for the system for the 4 NAND gates as shown in figure is very simple. Just do it. Pause the screen and attempt. Very easy question. Pause the screen and attempt. Pause the screen and attempt. Very easy question. Pause the screen and attempt. Okay, let's see. For A and B, you have input 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Okay, so first let's see when it is 0 and 0. When this both is 0, this one will be 0, this one will be 0. What is AND doing? First we will see AND, then we will do the NOT. That means opposite of that. So what AND is doing? Multiplication. So 0 into 0 is 0 and opposite of 0 is 1. So output here is 1. Are you getting my point? Now here it is 0 and here it is 1. Here it is 1, here it is 0. Okay. Now again, what AND will do? Multiply. 0 into 1 is 0 and opposite of 0 is 1. Again here 1 into 0 is 0 and opposite of 0 is 1. 1 into 1 is 1 and opposite of 1 is 0. So when you have A and B 0, 0, your output Y must be equal to 0. So see, two of the options is cancelled out. C and D is cancelled out. Now which you will try, in which it is different? See here, 1 and 0 it is 1, 1 and 0 it is 1. So don't check this. In both the options it is given 1, 0 then 1, 1, 0 then 1. Check this. If it is 0, 1 then either it is coming 1 or 0. You will get 1 among A and B. Are you getting my point? Just think like this. Don't do just hard work, labor work. So when we are taking it 0 and 1, 0 and 1, let me rub all this. Now we are taking 0 and 1. So this one is 0, this one is 1. So 0 into 1 is 0 and opposite of 0 is 1. So you will get 1 here, 0 here, 1 here, 1 here and 1 here. 0 into 1 is 0 and opposite of 0 is 1. So you are getting 1 here. And here if you see 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into 1 is 1 and opposite of 1 is 0. Now 0 into 1 is, see here, 0 into 1 is your 0 and opposite of 0 is 1. So what you will get here? 1. That means option A is correct. B, C, D is wrong. Simple or not? Very simple, and two questions are coming from this semiconductor. Complete chapter, your logic gate, transistor, diode and all these things. Two questions are coming and very simple. You can see how simple is it. And if you have seen my videos of this theory crash course, then it will be very, very, very easy. I've just taught you all the basic concept in a very, very simple way. Are you getting my point? So like and share this to other students also. And if you have any doubt, comment on the section below so that I can answer your doubts and you can connect with me. Are you getting my point? If you have any doubt, you can comment in comment section below. Even I will give you the link of Telegram group so that you can join there and you can ask any doubt that you want anytime. Again, next question. This one also I've told you in the theory only. I and V graph A, direct from theory, no need to do anything. Okay, so I'm skipping this. 2013 question. This was 2012. This was 2018. This was 2016, 2014. Are you getting my point? Now, next question. This also I told you. If I have not told you, then I am telling you that the phase difference, the common in common emitter amplification circuit using NPN transistor, the phase difference between input and output voltage is 180 degree. If you don't know, I am telling you. Okay, just remember. In common emitter configuration, the phase difference between output and input voltage is 180 degrees. Simple, just remember it. Next, this one is not a semiconductor question, but okay, you can take it here only. Majorly, it is a error and measurement question. Error and measurement question and very easy question, just attempt it. Pause the screen and attempt. You are able to see the question. Pause the screen. What it is given that? The current voltage relation of a diode is given by, this is the relation it is given. Applied voltage V is in volts and the temperature is in T. If the student makes an error measuring plus minus 0.01 volt. Error in measuring volt is 0.01 volt. While it is measuring the current of 5 milliampere at temperature 300 Kelvin. What will be the error in the value of current? Very simple. Very simple. The formula is given. Error in V is given. T is given. And I is given. You have to find the delta I. Simple. Very simple question. Just attempt it. Pause the screen and attempt. I am here with you. I will tell you the answer. Don't worry. Pause the screen and attempt. Okay, let's see, is it pause or playing? Okay, let's see. Now, what is it is given? I is equal to e to the power 1000 V by T minus 1. Okay, this is given. This is given. Done. This is given. Okay. Now, can I differentiate it? What I will say? Change in I, that means error in I. Is going to be equal to differentiation of minus 1. I can rub this. Differentiation of minus 1 is 0. Differentiation of constant is 0. Differentiation of constant is 0. Now, e to the power x. Differentiation of e to the power x is e to the power x. And then what we have to apply? Our chain rule. That means division, differentiation of your x. So first, e to the power x is e to the power x. Now, differentiation of the x that you have taken, 1000 V by T. So, that means AX, differentiation of AX is A. So, again, when you differentiate it, chain rule, so you will get 100 by T. Sorry, 1000 by T. Into delta V. Is this clear? We have just differentiated it, very simple, differentiated it, applied a chain rule, nothing more than that. Is it clear? Now, see, everything is given. What it is given that while measuring the current of 5 milliampere, that means this complete value is going to be equal to 5. So this value is going to be equal to 5 plus 1. That is going to be equal to, we are taking this minus 1 here. So it will become plus 1. So it will become 6. Are you getting my point? So value of this term is 6 into 1000 by temperature. T is 300, it is given. Delta V, error in V is given as 0.01. will give you error in I. Answer came. So simple. We have just differentiated it and put it the values whatever given in the question. So you got the answer. Just see. 0, 0, 0, 0 cancel out. 3, 2, 10 into this is 0.1. 0.1 into 2 is 0.2 ampere. Sorry, milliampere. Everything is in milliampere. See, here also, it is given in milliampere. So here also you will take, this one is also milliampere. So answer will also be a milliampere. So 0.2 milliampere. That means A. बल्ले बल्ले मजा आ गया. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? वेरी सिंपल, जस्ट डिफरेंशिएट इट एंड पुट द वैल्यूज. दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर एरर एंड मेजरमेंट दैट आई विल टेक योर क्लासेस फॉर योर रिविजन क्रैश कोर्स ऑल्सो. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? नाउ नेक्स्ट सिंपल, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट इट डाउन यू कैन राइट इट डाउन, वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट यू कैन राइट इट डाउन. Okay, let's move to another question. This NPN transistor question, very easy. What I told you, what is the input current, what is the output current, what is the current gain, what is the voltage gain, and what is the power gain. Very simple and only that much. Nothing more than that. Attempt. See what is given in NPN transistor. I told you whether it is NPN or PNP, anything. Every concept that I told you is same. Is used in common emitter configuration as an amplifier with 1 kilo ohm load resistance. First draw the diagram. Load resistance is 1 kilo ohm. That means output resistance is 1 kilo ohm. The signal voltage of 10 millivolt is applied across base emitter. That means your input current, because no other resistance is there. So your input voltage is 10 millivolt. This produces a 3 milliampere change in collector current. Delta IC is 3 milliampere. And delta IB base current, delta IB is 15 mu ampere, micro ampere. The input resistance and voltage, very easy. Just pause the screen for 1 minute and attempt. Okay. Let me tell you. रहा नहीं जा रहा हूँ. Okay. See. Ten 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 ten. First, let me make a diagram. Your load resistance is 1000 ohm. Your output voltage must be something. This one will be emitter. This one is emitter, this one is collector, and this one is base. See, what it is given, common emitter configuration. And I told you maximum time what will be asked. Common emitter configuration. Why? Because I told you this is having more efficiency, more amplification. That's why. Ding. Ding, 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 ding. I think I have made it opposite. Okay, this voltage, the supplied voltage is 10 into 10 raised to power minus 3 volt. 10 millivolt. 10 millivolt volt means 10 into 10 raised to power minus 3 volt. Here across this and this, there must be some internal resistance RI. There must be some internal resistance RI. Current from here is IB. Current from here is IC. And current from here is IE. Current from here is IE. Is this clear to everyone? Now, what will happen? This R is given, everything is given. Now, what is given is signal voltage of this. This produces a 3 milliampere change in collector current. That means, see, just write it down. Till now, I haven't solved anything. I am just writing down what it is given in the question. Delta IC change in collector current is 3 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Delta IB change in base current is 15 into 10 raised to power minus 6 ampere. Are you getting my point? I have just written what it is given. Nothing more than that. Now I will solve the question. What it is asked? The input resistance and voltage gain. The input resistance, this RI, is asked. And we know the Ohm's law. V is equal to IR. You know na? Sure? You know na? Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. So what will be your R? Delta V by delta I. Are you getting my point? Delta V by delta I. So what is your delta V? Your supplied voltage is 10 into 10 raised to power minus 3. What is your delta I? I here is IB. IB, and what is IB? 15 into 10 raised to power minus 6. It will cancel out and it will become 10 raised to power 3. So it will become 2 and this one will become 3. So 2 by 3 is approximately 0.67 into 10 raised to power 3 ohm. Or you can say that 0.67 kilo ohm. So that means A and D option is cancelled out. A and D option is cancelled out. Either C or D. This much is clear. What is we have done? Ohm's law, R is equal to V by I. V input is given. And which current we have to take? If it is common emitter, then we have to take the base current. And base current is given. Delta change in base current is 15 into 10 raised to power minus 6
ampere.
Is it okay? Okay or not? Now, what is it is asked next thing. Voltage gain. What I told you, what is voltage gain? Output voltage upon input voltage. Voltage gain is output voltage upon input voltage. Input voltage, it is given. Input voltage, it is given. So you have to find the output voltage, and that also I told you. What is output voltage? Voltage across your load resistance. So current from here is IC and resistance is 100. So simple, V is equal to I R. So what do you want V? So V will be going to be equal to I into R. So output voltage is current. Current IC is 3 into 10 raised to power minus 3 into R. Resistance is 1000. This and this cancel out. Upon input voltage. Input voltage is 10 into 10 raised to power minus 3. So it will become 0.3 into 10 raised to power 3. Voltage gain. Volt. It is given. Option is given. Okay. So it is going to be equal to 300. 300 it is given. D. Is it clear to everyone? See, I am just. Very simple. Delta IC is given. Delta IB is given. Load resistance is given. Input voltage is given. Now what left, yaar? What left? Very easy question. Bachcho ka sawal hai ye. Very simple, very easy question. Is this clear how to find? I have told you everything in the theory. Next, very easy again. Just read the question. Pause the screen and read the question. Pause the screen and attempt the question. Then I will tell you. See. You have to tell in the order which one it is. It is looking like simple diode. Every graph I have told you. And this one is Zener diode. So simple. Simple diode, Zener diode. Only one option is there. And if you see one thing. Light dependent resistance. See, light and resistance. Only one option is given. D. So it will be going to be in the last. C. C option, correct. What everything I told you, all the graph, this graph I told you. If you don't know the next two graph also, but from that two graph only you can get the answer. Are you getting my point? Very simple. And here it is common sense. See, resistance and intensity. So light dependent resistance, it's obviously going to be D option. Is it clear to everyone? Next question. And I think this is last. 2019 JEE mains, 9th January. Mobility of electron in a semiconductor is defined. Oh, I told you one formula. Resistivity and conductivity. Conductivity formula I told you. Just remember this formula. Charge of electron E into electron density into mobility of electron plus hole density into mobility of hole. Are you getting something? Coming? Okay. So just attempt this. Pause the screen. See what it is given. The density of electron. Sorry. Density of electron is given. Mobility of electron is also given. And what it is said? It is an n-type semiconductor, so ignore the hole. No need to take any contribution of hole, only electron. Very simple, n e mu. 1 upon n e mu. Just solve the question. Just pause the screen for 1 minute and solve the question. Pause the screen for 1 minute and solve the question. KGF polar gold fields. Okay, see. Let's see. Simple, I told you. What is your conductivity? Conductivity is E n mu. What is E? Charge of one electron. Charge of electron. Electron density. And what is mu? Mobility. Everything is given. See. Then the resistivity of the semiconductor, it is asked. So we know that what is resistivity? Resistivity is 1 upon conductivity. So it is going to be 1 upon N E mu. Just put the values. 1 upon, what is the charge of 1 electron? 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 into N. N it is given, 10 raised to power 19. 10 raised to power 19 into mu, mobility. How much it is given? 1.6. So this is cancelled out. So whatever it is coming, 1 upon 1.6 into 1.6, how much it is coming out? .39. Any option is there? 0.39, approximately 0.4. C option is there. See, very easy, only one. All the formulas, all the portions are from the theory that I told you right now. So just please see all these four videos, part four parts, and you will be able to do two questions that are coming this year, going to come this year. And I'm 100% sure if you just see this, make a notes, revise it properly, game over for the mains. Are you getting my point? So just be at home. Don't worry for this coronavirus and all. Take it as a positive, as already sir told you, and prepare for it. You have now more than 60 days to prepare for this exam. And easily you can do this, easily you can do for mains. Okay, for advanced you need a practice, very high practice for, but for mains you can do formula based question. You see all this, how easy questions these are, how easy questions. If you know the concept, if you have applied in one or two questions, you will be able to do nothing more in this. And when I am teaching then okay, so just see the video, and if you have any doubt then comment and like. Okay, so take care. Tata bye.